Okay, so here is my take two of a corn cob pin. Last time I was trying to do a double twist pin, and I don't think the pin was really quite thick enough. I've seen some done that way, but maybe you needed a different corn cob. So on this particular pin, the spacers are a lot bigger because it's a fountain pen. So first thing I'm going to do is get all these shavings out of here. I have a suspicion that the corn might pop out of the cob here, and I might need some pieces to glue back in. So I'm going to make sure that my tabletop is ready to catch the debris so I can make patches. So what we're going to do, we're going to take some super glue and this debris. And the debris has some of the blue and the brown. We're going to actually just pack it down into those spots with super glue. And then as we get down to the finish, you know, there's still a little edge left. As we get closer down to the finish size and we glue that stuff in, then it'll be just a matter of cleaning off the glue on the top. But we're going to definitely want to stabilize all this with glue, because right now, I mean, it's still a little bit flaky, and there's no way you'd want that coming apart under the pin. So it has to be very stabilized with super glue, for lack of a better term. So I'm experimenting a little bit here, and I put some thicker super glue, or CA glue, in there. And from the looks of it, it's filling it in. You can see the shine goes right across those vacancies. So as long as we're cool with the looks of those being kind of a hole, kind of a see-through, then that'll work. We won't have to use the debris to fill it in. But some of those big holes, I'm not convinced yet, but we'll see. We'll see. So an update here. I am turning this down, and we're just about there on the diameter. We're really, really close. And it's hard to tell on the camera here, but for the most part, like this little spot right here, is actually very smooth, even though it kind of looks like a hole. However, this up here was not. We had some holes. So it looks pretty crude, but I've actually glued some debris from earlier right onto those spots. And put some super glue on it. Use my quick dry stuff here. Spray it on it to accelerate her to get that to harden up. Now I'm going to use the lathe to turn it back off a little bit, clean those spots up, and we'll go it again. As you can see, we're progressing along here, and those spots are getting filled in. So a couple things you have to keep in mind here is that the corn cob pen is going to take a little longer to get done, just because there's so many cracks and crevices that you got to fill in. I'm doing a typical CA finish, and it takes a lot more work to get those little nooks and crannies filled in. It's going to be awesome when we're done. It's going to have all kinds of texture to it. Another note is I was using some super glue here, or CA glue, not even super glue, that I found at a local store that's not a finish CA glue. I don't know what the difference is, but I can tell you this stuff will end up dull. Now, what I've put on here is I've sanded, but I've never been able to get this other glue to finish, so I definitely recommend getting some finish type CA glue, and because that's just going to shine up so much better than this stuff, and it dries really fast too. They've got some good fast drying formula. In case you didn't notice, I'm watching to the camera here. I've got the blanks reversed. I need to flip one or the other. Okay, so we're back again here, and I'm putting glue on here like nobody's business. You can see just down at the bottom, if you see through the shadow right here, there's some nibs popping up. It, let me see them real good in the light. Some little bumps right here. Because I'm putting so much glue on, I'm just pouring it on and drying it quickly with my accelerator, because I'm really working building it up, and it's working. Those are the main spots right there, and down here with the little divots in. They're getting filled in, but because I've got bumps on it, I'm going to take my chisel and turn that down just a little bit, get some of that glue off, and that's going to help me in the sanding process anyway, because you can see there's a lot of grain building up because I have so many layers on there now. I'm probably standing about at least 10-15 layers. There we go. All shined up and done. Now this is a blue corn cob, and I don't think you're seeing things. It really doesn't look very blue. I see yellows and I see browns. If you look real close, there's some blue traces in there, but it's definitely not an outstanding blue, which is quite ironic because this is what I drilled out of the center. Not seeing that blue, so that's something to consider with corn cob, is that it may not come out 100% the color that it's looked like. Now, the design, I think it's a very outstanding design. This is a fountain pen, so it's going to be a chrome fountain pen. And I think chrome goes real well with this color. So we'll see how it looks. I'll be putting the pieces together and we'll show you the finished product. Well, there we go. Finished product. Couldn't be more happy with it. This is very happy that this is my very successful second attempt at a corn cob. Like I said earlier, this is blue corn cob. There's not a whole lot of blue in this, but there's some accents. There you go.